Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Today we are going to see one case of overhauling and testing of a slipring induction motor. Before we start, if you are new in my channel, please like, share and subscribe. Also press the bell icon for future update. So let us start. This is the case of slipring induction motor with power rating of 4.6 megawatt, and we will see its overhauling and testing. The motor data is as under. As I told you, the motor is 4600 kilowatt power rating. Stator voltages are 6.3 kilovolt. Current is 490 ampere. This is the stator current with frequency of 50 hertz, speed of 993 rpm. Rotor current will be 1580 ampere, and rotor voltages are 1770 volt. As this is a slipring induction motor with IP55, this motor was manufactured by WEM Germany. In this session we will see the following maintenance activities for this motor: their initial testing and dismantling of the motor, mechanical inspections of the parts, cleaning and washing of the windings, drying of the windings under strip heater, testing of the winding at room temperature, impregnation of the winding. Now, what is this? It is a process of applying a varnish to the windings for improving mechanical stability and electrical insulation, cleaning and painting of all parts, assembly of the motor with the new bearings, completing the work. The motor will be tested. We will also conduct the no load test and vibration measurements. When the motor was checked before overhauling, following values for the insulation resistance were recorded. Stator insulation resistance value measured with insulation resistance meter with 1000 volt DC measure. These results are phased to earth, and the values were recorded as 3.48 giga ohm with all phases to earth one by one. Then the test was also conducted for 5000 volt as well, and the values were recorded as 2.5 giga ohm. A rotor was also tested with and its insulation resistance measured at 500 volt DC measure, and the values were recorded as 63.4 mega ohm. Remember, the values are in 63.4 mega ohm. It means the value is low. And we also measure the resistance of the windings. First we have measured the resistance of the the stator windings, and the values are as mentioned. Then we measure the resistance, not insulation resistance, measure the resistance of the winding of the rotor. The values are as we have also measured the temperature sensors installed for the measuring the temperatures of the windings. The RTD sensor, basically PT100, were used to measure the temperature, and the values were recorded as shown. Similarly, for the drive end and the non-drive end sensors, the resistance measures are as shown. Before starting the overhauling, following condition for starting the overhauling of the motor, following findings were recorded. Motor rotor insulation value was very low, as we have saw in the previous slides. The value was very low. The rotor slip ring condition was uneven, and its runout was recorded as 0.2 mm. Rotor and stator windings were checked and found there were dust and carbon deposited from the coils. For overhauling of the motor, now we are going to start the overhauling. For the overhauling of the motor, first of all, the first stage is to dismantle the parts. So first of all, we will remove the coupling. This is how the couplings were removed. Bearings were taken out, and then the stator windings covers were removed. You can see the dust accumulation on the stator windings. Here you can also see the dust accumulation on the stator winding. You can see in different pictures were shown. There was the dust and carbon on the stator winding. Now this is the non-drive end side, the rocker assembly for slip ring were also removed. Now this is the rotor. You can see the dust and the carbon on the rotor as well. When the drive end bearings were dismantled, these were shown as this was the hub of the drive end bearing. These were the bearings. Now you can see the non-drive end bearing hub, the bearings. After removing the parts, now the next step is to clean. So first of all, we are going to clean. First of all, the rotor was cleaned. You can see the rotor. And this is another image of a rotor. Now the next step is the stator winding impregnation. This is done to protect the windings insulation. You can see the stator windings. After this activities, the winding needs to be dry out. So a strip heater were used to dry out the windings of the stator. After completing the work on stator and rotor, the parts also needs to be cleaned. It's the back end cover for the fan. The fan was also cleaned. The back end cover also cleaned and painted. This is the drive end shield. It's the non-drive end bearing shield. This part was also cleaned and painted. Cover for the stator winding cleaned and painted. After overhauling, the condition of the stator windings and the stator. The condition of the rotor. Now the motor is being assembled, the rotor is being inserted. One thing is very important: whenever we are going to insert the rotor into the stator, there must be some certain air gap. Now you can see the stator and the rotor with air gap. Now the motor is assembled and it is ready to be started as motor work has been completed. So now it's time to fairly test the motor. So we have done the insulation resistance for the stator at one kilovolt. You can see the insulation resistance value has been improved. Rotor insulation resistance value was very low, as we have discussed in previous slides. Now, as the maintenance has been done, therefore you can see the value has been much improved. It is 7.6 giga ohm. Before overhauling, it was in mega ohm. So now it has been much improved. The current value is 7.66 giga ohm. Insulation resistance has been improved for the rotor. Again, we have measured the winding resistance for the stator, for the rotor. Now, one thing very important, we have also measured the polarization index for the rotor. Now, what is the polarization index? Polarization index, or we can say PI, it is the ratio of insulation resistance value after 10 minutes divided by the insulation resistance value after 1 minute. Why it is done? Basically, it is to determine the contaminants and the physical changes in motor insulation. So this test is very important, and the test conducted, the values are shown. The value, the ratio was 4.95. It means the value is okay. So now, as we have done the testing, now we are also going to share the mechanical values or the mechanical checks which were also done. You can see from the shaft runout, the value is 0.02 on drive end side. The value is 0.02 on non-drive end side. Both values are okay. The slip ring runout was also measured. It is 0.02. The slip ring has been rectified because its value was initially 0.2. The slip ring was uneven. So now, as the slip ring has been rectified, so its runout value has been improved. We will discuss the how to improve the runout and how the runout is measured in another video. So keep watching. This procedure will be shown on another video. The bearings are also described, shaft dimension measured, and also the bearing bore sizes were measured. All the values were within the limits. After measuring the values, now it's planned to start the motor on load. Motor was started on load and the vibrations values were recorded. You can see all the values are within the limits. No value is above the limits. So that's all from today's. So you can ask any question. Your question will be answered accordingly. Thanks for watching my video.